Hello friends, welcome back to the Python programming session. In the previous sessions, we had looked into the sequential control statements and the decision or selective control statements. In this session, let's look into the repetitive or iterative statements. In the repetitive or iterative statements, we have two types, that is the for loop and the while loop. In iterative statement, a particular set of statements get executed repeatedly till the condition is satisfied. Once the condition becomes false, it comes out of the loop. It exits the loop. So we have two types, that is the for loop and the while loop. So in this session, let's cover the syntax of the for loop, code examples for the for loop, the syntax for the while loop, and code examples for the while loop. So firstly, syntax for loop. We have the for keyword and then the condition and then colon. Once we give colon, the statement will be indented. Four spaces will be given and it starts from the fifth position. We have to write the statement from the fifth position. And whatever statements are there within the for loop, they have to be indented by four spaces. And once the for loop statements are over, the sequential statements, for writing the sequential statements, we have to give back space and then write the sequential statements. So basically here we have the for keyword, a condition and colon, and the statements within the for loop have been indented. So this is the syntax for the for loop. Now going on to the code examples for for loop, let's see into the range, including the range data type. So for I in range of 5, print I. So here I is the iterative variable and range is the sequence in this particular case. So I keeps on iterating for the range items. Range is still 5, so it should be from 0 to n minus 1. So it will be from 0 to 4. So I keeps iterating from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4. So the output would be 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. It will iterate through n minus 1. So for this, let's look into the code, how it works practically. For loop, for I in range 5, colon, then the cursor will be at the indented position. I say print I. Now when I run the code, I get the output 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. That is still 5 minus 1. That is n minus 1. Since it starts at 0, it traverses till n minus 1. So this is one of the code example for the for statement, which is including a range sequence. Now let's have a list, example of the sequence being a list. In the list, I'm having apple, banana, grapes. So I give a for statement for x in LST1, print x. So x is the iterating variable, which initially will have the value apple, and then iterates and takes the value banana. It iterates through the loop and then takes the value grapes. Once grapes has been displayed, it has no other items in the list to be displayed. So it comes out of the for loop. So let's look into it practically. LST1 is equal to square bracket, stands for list. Apple, banana, grapes. So I'm having three fruits, that is apple, banana and grapes. Now I give a for loop for x in LST1. So for x in LST1 and then a colon. So here x is the iterating variable and LST1 is the sequence. So it iterates over the sequence and it prints the value of x, the value stored in x. So initially x will have apple. In the second iteration it will take banana. In the third iteration it will take grapes. And since it has reached the end of the list, it will come out of the for loop. Once it prints grapes, it does not iterate anymore. It comes out of the for loop and the sequential statements get executed. Suppose I say print end of program. So this sequential statement should not be indented. If it is indented, it becomes part of the for loop. So it has to be not indented. So we give a backspace and then write the statement. So now when I execute this program, I get apple, banana, grapes, and after the loop comes out, the sequential statement, that is end of program, gets executed. So this was, first one was with the range, second one is with the list, and the third one we shall see is for a string. Suppose my st1 is equal to Python. This is the string. For x in st1, print x. So it will iterate through each and every character in the string. Initially x will have the value p, then y, t, h, o, n. So it iterates through the string characters. So I have st1 equal to say Python. For I in st1 and then colon print I. So for I in st1, initially I will have p and then y, t, h, o and then n, and it prints it in the same sequence. So now if I run the code, I get the value p, y, t, h, o and then n. So this is how it displays the characters for the for loop. Now that we have covered some of the examples which include the for statement, now let's dive into the while statement. In the while statement, the syntax is, firstly, we initialize the loop variable. Then we check for the while expression. Then we have a set of statements within the while expression which are indented. And within the while statements, there is one more updation of loop variable. The loop variable gets incremented or decremented. And then we have then once it comes out of the while loop, the sequential statements get executed. So here I have an example, code example, wherein counter equal to 0. So this is the initialization of the loop variable. So counter, I'm initializing it to 0 initially. Then there is a while and an expression. In the expression, we are having counter less than 3. So it checks if counter is less than 3. Print counter, and then counter is incremented to 1. So this is nothing but updation of the loop variable which happens within the while statement. And once the counter is incremented, the while, it comes back again to the while condition and checks if the counter is less than 3. If it is less than 3, it will enter the while loop again and print counter, and again counter gets incremented. So this loop continues. Once counter becomes 3, then it is no longer lesser than 3. So it comes out of the program and prints end of program. So now let's see how it works in practically. Counter equal to 0. This is initialization of the loop variable. While counter less than 3 is the expression. Then I say print counter. Print counter. Then I update my loop variable, that is counter. Counter plus equal to 1. So here these are the two statements within the while loop. And then I give a backspace and say print end of program, which is a sequential statement. So here we are initializing the count variable, checking for the while expression, updating the count variable. So let's see, initially counter will be 0, so 0 will be printed, then it increments by 1. Counter is 1, it is less than 3, so counter value 1 would be printed, then 2 would get printed. When the counter value reaches 3, the while statement becomes false, and so it comes out of the while loop and it will follow the sequential flow of statements, and end of program would get printed. So now if I run the code, I get the value 0, 1, 2 and then end of program. So this is how the while loop works. Suppose I don't update my counter plus equal to 1, my counter remains 0 at all instances and it will enter into an infinite loop, which we should not be doing because it is very difficult and we have to forcibly terminate the program. So we have to be very cautious and update, and we have to update the loop variable within the while loop. So friends, these were some of the examples of the for loop and the while loop. If you have any doubts, please do reach to me out in the comment section. If you like my video, click on the like button and please do subscribe to get notifications of my new videos. Till then, see you. Bye bye.